actually not regular down here, then I think people go elsewhere. So I do try and stay till like at least 1:30 every day. Two coffees?
The thing that the problem they would have is they don't do the same as me. You know, you can put a burger bun in the corner, they're only going to come, you're going to come and have chili or pork, roast pork, or you're going to have a burger or bacon and egg. Which would you choose?
I've got people travelling from all over, they all come down, and sometimes they don't even go into the bike shop, they just come down for the food. Yeah, it's great. Yeah.
I normally come down for about 8 and then finish up about 1:30, 2 o'clock when it goes quiet. I've given leaflets out and a couple of people have got my number, yeah. And they some ring through, yeah. Now and again. More again than now. And I'm not that busy for most things to buy, but like the big burger vans, they sell a lot more. I mean, I don't sell that much. I could be busier, a lot busier, and it does get boring when you're not, and lonely, you know, just sat on your own really, aren't you, unless someone pops down, but no, I could be a lot busier.
Bread or rolls for breakfast? Beans or tomatoes or half and half. Bacon, egg and chips. The trouble is on a Friday, they all want it at the same time. You know, they all want it around the 10 o'clock, that last 9, 10 o'clock mark. And you know, if there's orders, there's 10, 15 on an order, then you know it's going to take you like 20 minutes to do it. You know, you've been here, well, you've been here for an hour and we haven't stopped yet, haven't we? Something to do all the time. At the end of the day, it's not rocket science. There's no stopping anybody doing what we do. But if they're not interested or they don't want to do it, then they're not going to get the customer there. I got a little dream. That's a drive-through curry house. You know where you've got McDonald's? Everybody eats curry. You had somewhere where you could drive through. Nobody. There's one in Birmingham. Yeah.
Well, as you know, we're supposed to be out of the recession. I don't think we are, personally. We've had a lot of redundancies around here. As I've been building up the customers, they've been going as well. So I've increased slightly, but on the whole, it's gone down as well. I would have been a lot busier, but for all the redundancies that's happened in the area, it's, you know, The leader around here is the gentleman down by Halo Foods, Quality Catering. It's me and him are neck and neck. He's a lot more busier than me because I'm slightly off the road and all the truckers go there. So yeah, he's leading. Only jest.
How long have you been here using this place for?
Since I've been here. How long have you been here? 2 years, 3 years? I'm buying a new bike today.
What are you buying?
Kawasaki.
Nice. Which one is that?
A GTR 14. Nice. The biggest one they do.
Nice, yeah.
And it's all about going around corners.
Yeah.
As fast as you can without falling off.
Can I have a look at your left hand? Bring it here. Bring it here. Turn it over.
What's that?
Oh, it's just something I'm into.
That's right. That's
the I got X-ray vision. Not only on top of that, I got a lot of other things. I can tell you everything about everybody in that whole area, and when they're gonna, you know, when they're gonna have whatever accidents, broken arms, whatever.
Burger man. I'm going to smack him. I'm going to hit him. I'm a burger man.
What would you describe yourself as then?
I don't call it a burger man anyway. I call it a catering unit.
Football, I always play football. I had Welsh trials and I broke my leg and I was left behind. That was my dream.
Relax. What's that? No, I got housework to do, washing to get in, ironing to do. A woman's work is never done.